Hello everyone, welcome once again to this online class. We are discussing about representation of geographical features. In this video we shall discuss about conventional signs and symbols and legend. How the signs and symbols are depicted or shown on the topographical map and it becomes easy to understand what it wants to tell about. So, first of all, the topographical map is not possible to draw all the actual and shape of the relief features. So, in that, the signs and symbols are used to show the meaning of those actual ground or actual landscape. The variety of features like natural made features or man-made features are shown with the help of different symbols and signs. And these symbols and signs, internationally it is known as conventional signs and symbols, give a lot of information regarding the map. The map that we interpret, basically the topographical map, when we want to understand, we need to know the signs and symbols that is used on the map. You can see these conventional signs and symbols are universally used and accepted. So anywhere, any countries, the maps that is prepared, we can understand because the signs and symbols are same. The meaning is same. So it is used and understood by all. By the signs and symbols. And there is a legend. After preparation of the map, below the map, a box, index box will be given, that is called legend. That means it will be giving hint, clues, or it will give idea that which all the color is shown on the map, what is the meaning of that, or which of the symbol is shown on the map, what is the meaning of that? It will be shown. That is known as legend. So there are few symbols that you must learn and we have to learn it to understand the topographical map. Let us see, these are the few symbols that we need to learn it. The first one, that is types of settlements. You can see there are three types of settlements: nucleated, linear and scattered. The settlements are shown on the topographical map with the red boxes. The red boxes are settlements. That means it is a town or a village or city where the people are settled. And the pattern, it is called nucleated pattern if the red boxes are close together. If they are close together, the pattern will be asked as nucleated. If the red boxes are drawn across a river or across a road, that means it is known as linear pattern, linear settlement pattern. Remember, the red boxes which are shown across both the sides of the river in a line, or it will be shown on the roads, both the sides across the road, that will be known as linear pattern of settlement. Then we have scattered. Scattered means it is far away from each other. That means the red boxes will be away from each other. Even if one red box is present in one particular grid square, it will be called as scattered settlement pattern. Then we have monuments and buildings. These monuments and buildings, like temple, chhatri, church, mosque, then post office is shown with PO, capital letters, then again PTO, post office and telegraph office combined together. Then we have PS, police station, DB, dak bungalow is there, IB means it is inspection bungalow, RH means rest house, and then we have RS, that means railway station. Then these telegraph lines are shown with the help of it is printed on the map, and it is dotted black lines will be shown. Then we have The roads are shown with the red colors. All the roads, different types of roads are there that is used on the topographical map. Don't mix with the common roads that is there, state highways, national highways or expressways. These are used on the map, and this term has to be used only on topographical map. Is it clear? So now you can see roads are drawn on the topographical map with red lines or red color. You can see metal roads, if it is double line, red color, double lines will be having little bit darker line, it will be having, that is known as metal roads. If it is drawn with dashes lines, the dashes two lines, then it is known as unmetal roads. If it is drawn with dashes single line, it is drawn with red color. If it is drawn with dashes single lines, it is known as pack track. That means the donkeys, mule or any other animals go on that way. Then you can see cart track. Cart track is single red line where the bullock carts, horse carts will be moving, and during the rainy seasons it becomes muddy. Then we have footpath. Footpath basically shown on the topographical map where the green color area is there. That means the forested area where people go by foot or on foot they go. That's when it's known as footpath. Footpath. They can remember this will be dotted red lines. So clear. Then we have drainage patterns. How drainage patterns are shown on the topographical map. There are three main drainage patterns, and then again we have the minor disappearing streams. So dendritic, all the black lines that is shown on the topographical map are known as drainage patterns. The black small lines that is shown on the topographical map. Dendritic, trellised, radial. Dendritic, that means if the drainage patterns are looking like a tree, dry tree, the branches of the dry trees on the particular grid, it is known as dendritic pattern. If it is shown with the main river having the angle, it will make bit right angle, it is known as trellised. And if it is radial, from one point of high spot, that means spot height, the rivers are originating or streams are originating, the dry streams are originating, is radiating from one point, that is known as radial pattern. And the disappearing streams are shown with one line and ending with dashes or dotted lines. So these are the few patterns of the drainage. Don't take tension of what is about these patterns of drainage. It will be helpful for you in the 10th standard. So be familiar with the names, and then when you are given topography to understand, to interpret, obviously you will be able to understand. Then we have definitions. These definitions you must learn it. You must learn it, so don't forget. So first one, brackish. Brackish means water which is unfit for drinking and for irrigation. So brackish means water, salty water which is unfit for drinking and irrigation purposes. Broken ground will be there, which is opposite side of the bracket that is shown in the topo sheet. Broken ground means when there is a flood comes and it dries up, so top layer of the surface becomes broken, and it is termed as broken ground. We have causeway. Causeway means in a minor stream, a raised platform on a minor stream. So that is causeway. Then spot height. Spot height means height of a place from the mean sea level. Height of a place from the mean sea level. It will be indicated with the dot along with the number. Then we have triangulated height. Learn the definitions. That means height of a place from the mean sea level, and it is surveyed by the triangulation method. It is shown on the topographical map with small triangle followed by the number. So remember that triangulated height will be shown on the topographical map with small triangle with the number. Then we have contour lines, the brown colors which will be showing the height of a mountain or hill. Then we have form lines. Form lines, the dashes, contour lines, where the contours are drawn where the surveyors are not accessible to the place, remote areas. Then we have depression. Depression means the hollow on the ground that is created by the created on the sand by the wind. That is a depression. So open scrub. Open scrub means it is a place where uncultivable area, it is barren land area that is shown with the white patches of the color. Then we have fire line. Fire line is very important. Fire line is drawn on the map to prevent the spread of fire. Then we have stony waste. Stony waste means a place where it will be shown with the white color, but it will be printed as stony waste. That means the area is covered with rocks and boulders. It is not suitable for cultivation. Then we have sand dunes. Sand dunes will be shown with the dotted brown color. So these are the few conventional signs and symbols that you must learn it. Be familiar with all the symbols that is there in your 7th standard, so it becomes very easy for you to understand, interpret in the higher studies or in the higher classes. Hope I made it very clear. So in the next class we can discuss about the second chapter, and before that I will be giving you the question answers. Write it down, maintain the notebooks. Any queries, any doubts are there, please do ask personally in the WhatsApp. Many of you are sending the notes for corrections. I appreciate that. So all of you are asked to maintain the notes, and then the notes will be asked to submit in the first week of May. So before that, be ready with your notebooks. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a nice day. God bless you.